Hi, I want to talk about debits and credits. Last time I went too long and I couldn't upload it to YouTube. So let me talk really fast. Debit, we talked about the accounting equation a minute ago. Assets are on the left side of the accounting equation, and liabilities and equity are on the right side of the equation. That can kind of keep us straight to begin with. Debits and credits, the convention of debits and credits mean left and right. So every transaction, like in the accounting equation, takes at least one debit and at least one credit, and you're not finished with that entry until you've got one of each, or you can have multiple as long as they balance. And it's a different balancing from the accounting equation. But where they are on the accounting equation sort of determines, well, it really determines how they are. So if assets are on the left side, then they're going to have debit. Debit is just a synonym for left. Left, debit. Credit is right. So all the assets, like cash, our favorite one, accounts receivable, equipment, have debit balances. So whatever their balance is, to increase them, you would do the same thing. So if the balance is debit, you increase it with a debit. So what would you do to decrease it? Now, a T account has no negatives and no positives. It's just positioning. It's all about position. So if you want to increase it with a debit, what would you do to decrease it? You would credit it. So that's what you're going to do with assets. You're going to debit to increase them and credit to decrease them. And every asset has its own little T account. So you don't want to have, like, there's no such thing as an assets T account. Every one of them is separate. Then on the liabilities and the stockholders' equity, they're on the right side of the accounting equation. So when I think of right, I use a synonym, credit. So to increase a liability, give me an example of a liability. Accounts payable. So if we buy something on credit, we bought a table a few minutes ago, a table. That would be an asset. We would debit that asset table. We would credit accounts payable. So to make a liability go up, we credit it. Now, if we pay off that debt that we owe our neighbor for the table, we have $25, say, sitting here as a credit. If we want to go pay that bill, what would happen? It would take the opposite. So if it was a credit, it would take a debit to accounts payable to pay off the table. But we wouldn't buy the table again. So the other side of that would be a credit to what? Cash. So it'd be a debit to accounts payable and a credit to cash. So that's how liabilities work. Now, stockholders' equity is more complicated. And we talked about how complicated it was in the last video I did. So stockholders' equity is on the right side of the equation. So normally accounts, we want the accounts to increase it with credits. That's true about common stock, retained earnings, and revenue. All those have positive increases to stockholders' equity, don't they? Can you think of some accounts that are minuses to stockholders' equity? Expenses and dividends. So expenses reduce stockholders' equity because they come through net income, they bring it down, and then that brings retained earnings down, and then that brings stockholders' equity down. The same thing happens with dividends. It brings retained earnings down. So both of those accounts, even though they're sitting over here in the right-hand side of the family, they've got debit balances. So let's pick an expense. Let's say rent. Let's say Maggie has to pay rent for I don't know, for her space on the street. So if she has rent expense and it's going to cost her $10 a month to do it, what would that entry be? Well, if she pays the cash, I always tell people to remember the cash. So if she pays cash for $10, then paying cash is going to do what to that asset? Bring it down. So we're going to credit the cash. Now we need to find a place for the debit. The debit is to rent expense. And it's just like the account equity. It's kind of confusing because you're thinking about what's happening to the total stockholders' equity. Does that make sense? So every entry has got a debit and a credit. And then when you're finished, you can balance these out. And we can talk about that later, because you'll total up all your sides and then take the bigger side and subtract it from the smaller side. And that's where you're going to have it. Now let's do one more before my time runs out. Let's say Maggie sells on credit. Now what happens if she sells some lemonade on credit? So a credit, the word on credit or on account means one of two things. It can be an accounts receivable or an accounts payable. So Maggie sells lemonade to the next door neighbor for $5 and he doesn't have any money. So for $5, she is going to debit something, and for $5, she's going to credit it. Well, she can't debit cash because she didn't get it. So she gets another account that's just as good as cash, accounts receivable. And since it's an asset, it's got that debit balance, she debits accounts receivable, doesn't she? What does she credit? She credits revenue. So the revenue makes, remember, helps retain net income through retained earnings, stockholder equity go up. So it's got a normal credit balance. Do you see the difference? Now let's do one more. Maggie's doing so well. She got money from her mom and she started the business, and now she's going to give some dividends. So she wants to give a dividend of a dollar because she did so well. So if she gives that dividend of a dollar, what's it going to do? It's going to credit cash. Now we always put the debits first in a journal entry. We're not even talking about that. We're just talking about theory. So we credit cash and debit dividends. The placement of all these is really important, because once we have balanced, we can start pulling our trial balance. And we'll do that next. I'm going for my walk.